Harlan Coben's Shelter episode 3 ends on major Ashley cliffhanger. Just who exactly is Ashley, the missing girl at the center of the drama? Warning, this article contains spoilers for Harlan Coben's Shelter episodes 1-3. Prime Video's latest tense drama, Harlan Coben's Shelter, is the latest drama to land on the platform and immerse viewers in the twisty kind of tale that the acclaimed mystery writer is best known for. The series follows teenager Mickey Bolitar, Jaden Michael, who is faced with a new life in suburban Castleton, New Jersey after the sudden death of his father. As a new guy at school, his surroundings are slightly tricky to navigate, as the first three episodes in the series show. But his school experience is soon improved in a major way with the arrival of another student, Ashley Kent, Samantha Bugliaro. The pair hit it off instantly, becoming a rock for one another in their new classes and are clearly in the early stages of a cute romantic storyline. As is the way of any Harlan Coben thriller, though, it's a short-lived relationship as Ashley soon disappears, prompting Mickey and his newfound friends to go looking for her and any clues as to where she could have gone. Aside from the trio's amateur sleuthing slowly unfolding in the series' initial three-episode premiere, viewers were also shocked by the cliffhanger at the end of episode 3, prompting us to truly consider who Ashley really is. Does she have a connection to Mickey that we, and he, don't know about? And more importantly, does Ashley have a connection to the enigmatic Bat Lady, Tova Feldshuh? Well, in the episode's final moments we were thrown plenty of revelation. Not only do we find out that the mysterious stranger breaking into Ashley's school locker is popular cheerleader Rachel Caldwell, Sage Linder, but we also find out that Bat Lady is not such a stranger after all. Remember the heroic child who we learn about via Mickey's history class? The same one who rescued children from Nazi concentration camps? Well, her name was Lizzie Sobic, and it turns out that Bat Lady seems to be her. When Mickey confronts Bat Lady about what she knows about Ashley and his father, Bat Lady recalls her own past. We soon see a black and white flashback of her life and see butterflies etched into trees, the clear signs the children followed in order to try and get to safety. But most, as Bat Lady explains, weren't as lucky, and we see a troop of Nazi soldiers capture some of the children. When we hear a shot ring out, one of the children in the group screams out, but her mouth is quickly covered by an older child. That older girl has a prisoner number on her arm, and when we pan out and back to the present day, we realize Bat Lady is the girl all grown up and still has the prisoner number on her arm. Bat Lady then tells Mickey that they share something in common, and through a quick series of flashbacks, we see that the paramedic who tended to Mickey's father Brad, Christopher Polaha, after his fatal car crash turns out to be the same person as the Nazi soldier who ordered the children's killings in Bat Lady's past. Could it be that they could be relatives, therefore being people in the same bloodline that are responsible for major deaths in both Bat Lady and Mickey's lives? That's the only thing that could be relatively possible, as it doesn't look as though the character has aged from the 1940s to now. Well, while that is certainly a cliffhanger and a half, the episode didn't end there. We then see Ashley tearfully looking down at her phone and looking at the picture of her and Mickey.